Hi, it's Mike, the Healer Gut Guy, and today we're going to talk about, do antibiotics cause gut dysbiosis? And the answer is surprisingly no, they do not. There are millions of people who take antibiotics, like on a yearly basis, you know, maybe once, twice a year, and they have a perfect gut microbiome, and they do not have digestive issues. Let that sink in. I know your holistic, brainwashed mind right now wants to be like, oh, you got to eat all these yogurts and all, and avoid antibiotics and stuff like that. And, oh, the gut microbiome this, the gut microbiome that. Hey, how's your gut microbiome doing? Is it still crap? Yeah, it's still crap. And it's because we don't understand what's going on at, you know, what's going on in your gut, what's going on in your organism as a whole. Why is it? Ask yourself this right now. Say it out loud and, you know, be truthful to yourself. Ask yourself, why can your friends and family eat anything that they want, take antibiotics on a yearly basis? You know that they are. You know they haven't had any probiotics. You know that. Stop ignoring the truth and actually look, open up your eyes, take off the holistic bullshit glasses and look. Look, go look at your family members. Go look at your friends in the family. They are eating whatever they want. They have zero probiotics in their diet, just about, and they take antibiotics on a yearly basis, yet they don't have digestive issues. Look at this. And why? And then let's look at you, on the other hand. You've been taking probiotics. You've been, disinfecting and all this stuff, and you still can't have a piece of cake on your birthday. Why? I'm going to tell you why. It's because gut disease and your gut microbiome is controlled in your brain. It is due to a particular type of stress, the way that you individually experience the world. Your digestive issues, most of you, especially those with colitis, started after a very stressful period in your life. So during this hard-to-digest event, this person makes me sick to my stomach, guys. We have these phrases in our languages, and not just in English, but in Spanish and all the other languages. You know, all the other languages that my students speak, they've given me tons and tons and tons of different phrases of, I can't digest this. I can't make sense of this. I can't accept this. What does your digestive system do? It digests things, and it is controlled by the brainstem, the oldest part of the brain. It does not know the difference between a piece of food stuck in your stomach and something imaginary or something right in front of you. It does not know the difference. It's controlled by the oldest part of the brain. It's very primitive. When you experience something, a conflict shock, something stressful that catches you off guard, your body's going to try to help you survive. All of our organs were designed for a very specific survival purpose. And the gut is going to try to help us digest this hard to digest thing in our life by creating extra gut cells. And when this thing gets resolved or partially resolved, that's when we go into the healing phase and we get rid of these extra gut cells. And these extra gut cells get removed with the help of bacteria and fungi. That's where the messed up gut microbiome comes from. Now, when this thing doesn't get fully resolved, when we start to develop these bad emotional habits and it's just this issue that never dies in our life, it keeps on reoccurring, and then we start blaming food, this program stays on and on and on for a long time, and that's what causes the dysbiosis, because the brain is what controls what type of cells get produced in your gut. If you study terrain theory long enough, you'll eventually come across something called the somatid cycle, where it shows how your own cells can make bacteria cells, microbacteria cells, they can make fungi cells, they can make yeast cells, they can make cancer cells. These cancer cells are, they're not trying to kill you. Usually cancer cells are, it's cell adaptation. These extra cells are trying to help your gut perform better to digest this hard to digest thing in your life. Have you ever gotten a colonoscopy and you see polyps in your colonoscopy? Those are the extra gut cells. Those were tumors. They were extra cells designed to help you digest and absorb this hard to digest thing in your life. And the bacteria and fungi were removing them. They were removing flesh. They were removing that excess flesh we no longer need. You see how this is an intelligent design where, you know, the body's not trying to kill you. The bacteria and fungi are trying to kill you. Bacteria and fungi helped develop us. Bacteria and fungi are the oldest organisms on the planet. We would not be here without them. We are more bacteria and fungi than we are human cells. The brain controls the production of candida, fungi, and bacteria in your gut. Because I've seen too many people take billions and billions of CFU of probiotics every day and take all the antifungals and stuff like that and get absolutely nowhere. And then literally overnight or within a couple of days, they get rid of all their food intolerances just by changing what's going on up here between your two ears. Your gut microbiome is controlled by your psyche. It is controlled by your psyche, guys. And I want to help you guys be able to have cake on your birthday again and not have to be food OCD for the rest of your life. All the while, you are ignoring it. You are blind. Open up. Open up your eyes. Stop ignoring the truth. Look at the truth. Why do your friends and family eat whatever they want? They take antibiotics on a yearly basis, yet they don't have gut issues. Yet you are doing everything right and still have gut issues. Because it's not about how many probiotics you eat and how many disinfectants you take. It's about your brain. It's about what's going on in your psyche. That's how you turn off gut disease, guys. That's how you do it. So guys, if you have any questions, go down below and leave them in the comments section down below and I'll answer them. Also hit that subscribe button and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.